This is a block of breast. Right here.
Could you imagine if they had to make bras like that?
Be very
square bras.
Be very okay. BJ and Nick are here with us, Mary, from the Hazleton Downtown Athletic Club. Mm-hmm. And of course, BJ and Nick have been on with us before talking about fitness.
Exactly.
Yeah, of course. But tonight we're going to talk about nutrition and fitness and how they go hand in hand. So welcome, guys. Thanks
welcome.
For coming on again. We appreciate it.
I know nutrition's a very important thing for people because a lot of people were raised in certain ways and you follow your ethnic background and people wonder why they gain weight, not nutritionally balanced. So, BJ, tell us, why does nutrition play an important part to the fitness regimen?
It plays an important part because people think once they start to exercise, it gives you pretty much an open door. Just eat what you want. I can go in, exercise. I get to go have a piece of pizza. I can have a burger. I can do what else I want. And then they wonder 2 months down the road why they're not losing any weight and they're actually gaining weight. So it really plays an important part because you have to be taking in less than you actually burn throughout the entire day. And a lot of people don't understand just how much they take in unless they see something written in front of them and say, okay, this is what this is and this is how much this is. And it's an eye-opening experience once they kind of figure out, wow, I have to watch what I eat while I exercise.
Some people are emotional eaters, you know, and they realize that then. I know a lot of those where I can't eat when I'm upset. You're probably like that too. You burn
I eat all
a lot
the time.
Of yeah, you look it.
I do.
You so look it. Yeah, but eating little portions all day is the right
better.
Way to
Isn't
do it,
it
really.
It's good raising. It's good.
Exactly.
Yeah, small portions a lot of times.
Small portions. My daughter is. Ray Lynn's always eating.
That's good.
And she doesn't gain any weight.
No, well, if you ever watch kids, they eat and they know what to eat. And then
they're,
when they're done, they don't want any more. Where we are... Gotta finish that dish. How were we raised?
Well, how about the portions of plates? I mean, the portions are so huge anymore.
Mm.
When you go in a restaurant.
Oh, my God. It's insane.
I take half home for tomorrow.
My wife and I usually split an entree.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, because you can't.
No, you can't.
The portion sizes is really key when you're talking calories. And we'll get into that with our props.
So let's talk about these props because we got... These are definitely unique props. There's a baseball. One time in the third grade, I ate a baseball.
A dirty one?
Anthony Kozlowski hit me right in the mouth, and I ate the whole thing. It was great. And we have this potato, and the spaghetti, and the square chicken breast. Okay, go ahead. You're on.
Basically what it is it kind of gives people a visualization for when they're out. And when you go... Like you were saying, when you go out to eat, you get these huge plates with all these portion sizes on it when you're not realizing how many calories you're actually taking in. So it kind of gives people an easy way to remember.
Okay.
3 ounces of meat is about the size of a deck of cards.
3 ounces of
three
meat.
3 ounces. Mm-hmm. Or, if you can't remember that, basically about the size of your palm.
It's 3 ounces.
And well, usually when you get a huge thing, it's like, the
yeah,
plate
right,
is the meat itself.
Right.
I mean, this itself, 3 ounces of chicken is 168 calories.
Mm. Okay.
So if you multiply that by three times,
wow.
I mean, you're taking in close to almost 400 calories, 500.
Just with chicken.
Not
counting anything else on the plate.
Including your drinks or anything else.
Right.
And then 2 ounces or a half cup of spaghetti is about the diameter of a nickel.
Okay.
And everyone knows about the size of a nickel.
Right.
So it kind of just gives a nice, easy visualization. Same thing with a baseball. This basically equals a half cup of rice or a half cup of vegetables. And same thing, when you go out, all of a sudden you get like this whole plate.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all vegetables or it's all rice or it's anything that you want. And same thing, this alone, a half cup of green beans is 22 calories.
Okay.
Half cup of rice, you're looking at almost 200 calories.
Wow.
So, I mean, you put that along with your chicken breast and your spaghetti, and then some people say, oh, I just want a baked potato because it's a healthy...
Right.
A healthy thing that you have. It is, but this, about the size of a tennis ball, a 12-ounce potato is 372 calories alone with
no
sour cream, butter, cheese.
Butter,
right,
afraid,
sour cream. Yeah.
So we have what, 300 here. How much?
168 there.
3, 4, 6, 8.
You have 210 with your spaghetti, 22. That's the whole plate okay. itself is 772 calories.
700 and
for one meal.
Wow, and that's not a lot.
That's not.
I
a
mean,
lot.
Compared to what right, you see in a exactly. restaurant, this is like.
And you're talking how it's cooked as well. I mean, that matters mm-hmm. as well.
Then we throw on the butter.
The butter and the cream sauce.
Exactly. Cream sauce or whatever.
So that's a lot of your downfall.
Easily be 1,000 calories in one meal.
Right.
And then people eat like that throughout the day, and it's like...
Sure.
And they wonder.
Nick, now a lot of, you know, your nutritional consults, you do... Everybody's individual because you're telling portion size, but your size is bigger. You'd have to eat a little bit
right.
more.
Right. One thing we do when people typical... sign up for a typical membership, we'll not only will we give them an orientation around the gym and a few exercises to get started, we'll do a nutritional consultation. With them, we'll go over five components of fitness, which is your food intake. Again, she spoke about taking in a certain number of calories, and we give clients information on exactly how many calories they need. You have cardio, respiratory activity, which is treadmills, bikes, stuff like that. That's where you're going to burn a lot of your calories. You'll have supplementation. A lot of people get worried and think supplementation, I'm going to get big and take all kind of strange things, but a multivitamin is considered supplements. Weight training, that has several benefits, and then there's the fifth components working with one of us is for personal assistance. Now, what we do, we have them fill out a series of sheets based on their current lifestyle, their dietary habits, and medical history as well. We'll put that in a computer. We'll print out a menu for them, a specific number of calories as to what they need to achieve their goals, whether they want to gain weight or most commonly lose weight.
Okay. We were talking about, I wanted to mention to you the proper time to eat. You know, we were talking about before, a lot of people eat supper like late, mm-hmm. like yeah. 8 o'clock.
I know where you're
o'clock.
Going with that.
Like when... You know, I don't know how you are, Mary, but like my wife and I were like, we'll eat at 4 or 5 o'clock, mm-hmm. the latest.
Yeah.
If we eat at 6 or 7, it's like,
yeah.
this is like late.
Yeah.
It won't
Once
kill
in
you.
A while.
There's nobody inside of you with a clock.
Okay, right. Tell me about it.
It's all about calories. Okay. If you're eating every so many hours, small portions, maybe 200 calories average each meal, you'll do all right. If you ate, like I said, it's all about calories. If you're diet was composed of 2,000 calories and you ate anything else over that, you would gain weight. If you ate a piece of cheesecake and that got you to 2,000, if you ate a stick of broccoli or a stick of celery after that 2,000, that's the celery is going to put on weight.
I see. So it's after that certain
it's calories.
Amount of
it's
calories.
Not necessarily
calories.
What oh. you have
the
smarter
time
choices.
Is really not that critical.
No, you have smarter choices as opposed to junk food versus vegetables. Mm-hmm. But if you eat It's all about the total number
okay.
of calories.
And that's the bottom line. Is that the bottom line?
Taking in as the calories that you need along with the exercise, you should always be able to reach your fitness goals.
All right, very
and
good.
And if you're confused, you go down and you talk to BJ and Nick, and they'll clarify things, because the sauce matters, dressings.
And, of course, take some
time to get your way to go.
Okay, and we'll be right back. Thanks, guys. Thank you very much.